Hello, what's up everyone? Gotta fix this. I'm bummed out right now because Iowa lost in the national championship game. I get dumbly emotional about the dumbest things, and I was tearing up not because they lost, because other people were anytime I like watch other people get emotional, I get emotional. I don't know why. Like, it's something stupid. If I'm like watching a sports moment, I love like good sports moments, but like crazy, like, you know, if someone's getting really emotional during like something, or yeah, Caitlin Clark, she just came off for her last time ever playing college basketball, and she was losing it. It makes me so like teary-eyed. Cause it's her last chance. It was a good game. I thought they were gonna come back. They were down by 12. Man. Maybe. Yeah, let's try it. Man, that's like, as a college student playing, she played 4 years. Well, she was there for 5 years. So she's playing for 4 years, but she was there for 5 years. There's another girl on the team, Kate Martin, and she's incredible. And she's been there for 6 years. And their career just came to an end. And Kate Martin, isn't going to the WNBA. It's like your playing career is done. Back-to-back championship losses. So that just hurts. That just sucks. Man. I'm like an empath in that way. Because I like feel what they're feeling. And it is so devastating. It's like, especially because that's their life. Like, now they're into adulthood. Like, Caitlin Clark's gonna go on and make tons of money. But like, for Kate Martin, like, she goes to like normal life. Which just sucks, because she's been like, her whole life has been devoted to like basketball up until this point. And she's like stayed on an extra year as a grad student to play. And it's over. Even if she won, it would be over. But man, something about that just cuts me. Anyway, I'm off my rant. Let's do strands. This'll all blow over. This'll all blow over. I feel like bygone is in here somewhere. No way, Katie, it's your birthday today. It's my birthday tomorrow. Wow. Happy birthday. Nice, I love that. Birthday Queen. Yeah, this song isn't a dancing queen, it's Birthday Queen. Honestly, rather than sing Happy Birthday to you, your friend should sing this song. Singing the Birthday Queen. That would be so much better. I actually kind of love that. Where's Last? Nandella, you said you see Last, but I don't see Last. I can't see. Man. Table. And like table this. Bottom left. I see it, but I can't piece it together. Wait, did you say bottom left? Oh, bottom right. Sorry. I don't know why I read bottom left. You literally typed bottom right. Weather. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know why that. I saw that. Like, what the heck is this? Weather is like twice in this. No, where's Last? How have I still not found Last? Last was wrong. Bummer. Right. What the heck? Feather instead? Wait, feather? Instead of weather? Yeah, I like that. What the heck is this? This will all blow over, feather. I'm not getting flagged on YouTube so far, so that's kind of nice. I don't know where they... What do they tell me? I forgot where they tell me that I'm against copyright. I think this is good. Lightweight. Oh, nice. Light... Wait, nice, there we go. Yelloon. Straw. No, balloon. Balloon, oh, gotcha. Eyelash. Bubble up, bubble top on the top. Bubble and paper. Nice. Well done, guys. That's a cool one. It was very methodical, very geometric. Man. All right, letterboxed. Nemo and Katie, you're up. Solving four words. blow over. Ooh, that would have been good. Furnace. Oh my gosh. No. Can't do furnace. Why can't... Oh, yeah. Ah, bummer. I was about to go crazy. Finch. Flinch. Like Justin Flinch Fetchley. Flinch Fletchley. Unflinching. Wow. Is there ever a way to solve it in one? That would be insane. Unflinchingable. Lur. Bureau into unflinching. Wow. I've never had success spelling bureau. Wait, no, I can't do bureau. Bureau. There it is. Ay, ay, ay. That's insane. Garbage could have worked after unflinching. Ooh, nice, Becky. I didn't even see that. Archaic. Archaic's another good word. Man, you guys are impressive. Wow. That's insane. Connections. I know your father. I just want to play that. So you guys don't always think I'm crazy when I say this.
You know my father?
Correction, I know your father.
I don't know why. That's one of my favorite parts in that whole movie. I mean, it's like the greatest movie ever, but... Rafiki is such a good character.
You know my father?
Correction, I know your father.
I love it so much, I don't know why.
What's up, Wes? Where's your toy? Come on, come say hi to everyone. Come here. Come here. Wanna say hi? Oh, you're being all bashful.
Oh, you wanna play, huh? Yeah, you didn't have Lion King memorized, and you didn't really live. Stable, sty, ping pen, pig pen, and... Andela, what's your help on this one? Charlie? Like a Charlie horse? Wait, stable horse, Charlie horse, dark horse, crazy horse? Or prize horse? Dump horse? Wait, gift horse? Wait, time out. Before you do firm, stable, solid, sound. What is the horse one? You get a Charlie horse. You're a dark horse. Crazy horse? Stable horse? Is it gift? Gift horse? I've never heard of a gift horse. Weird. Firm, stable, solid, sound. Never look a gift horse in the mouth? What? Pig pen, sty, dump, mess. Jack in the box? Oh, Cracker Jack's not Jack in the box. Jack in the box is the terrible food chain. I've never heard that saying before. You can sort of tell a horse's age by the mouth? Wow, that's kind of crazy. Apparently, I have the gums of a 70-year-old. That's what my dentist recently told me. Because I have receding gums, a receding gum line on a few different teeth. All right, Wordle. No, I don't brush too hard. She said it was because my teeth were misaligned. Not to be ungrateful when someone gifts you something, don't complain. Interesting. Brush. Brush is a good word. Ah, oh, I was hoping for... Ooh, brush is not a good first word. Talon. Ooh, that gives us a lot of info. Lorax. It might be Lorax. Imagine if it was Lorax. No, it can't be because of R. Lodi. Ooh, olive is a great word. Ooh, wow. Alive. Oh, wait, no A, no O, hold on. No E. Viola? Voila. Sorry. Becky, this one good? We're all waiting Becky's approval. Voila. Voila. Trust Becky. Becky is the Wordle queen.
Hi, bud.
Oh, you got your bone. You got your bone. Man, I am so bummed. Iowa lost. I haven't been this into a basketball game since 2024. And that year will only ring significance with Katie. It was the greatest sports year of my life. But I haven't been that into a basketball game since then. All right. Spelling bee. See, Becky or Katie gets it. All right. We need to get 202. Wow, that's a lot. Rain, train, rant. Ooh, taciturn. Is that a pangram? Nice. Runt. Nice, Toodles. That was a good word. Curtain. Let's curtain that. Cecilia, that's okay. That was another pangram. That was impressive. Currant. Ooh, currant. Anybody have black currant wine? It's good. I've never had. Can someone enlighten me on this? Is orange wine any good? Is this like a new big thing? I feel like on like Hinge, I feel like 10 people's profiles that I just saw was like orange wine is the best. We're going back to YouTube. We're switching back and forth a lot. So I'll stream on Twitch every once in a while, but YouTube seems to be getting more people. Like gross. I typed in gross. Wait, Cecilia, you don't like orange wine? Tactic. No, I'm missing the R. Tantric. The wine, not a word guess. Tartan. Cecilia, what's your favorite wine? Circuit. I think I have train already. Yeah. Trant. I don't know. Truon. It's a good word. Nemo, thanks. I am very unhinged with this stuff. Honestly, I like Twitch better, but I might just keep doing the crossword. So this is kind of my trait. Narc. White Chardonnay. I'm actually a fan of white wine more than red wine. Runic. Ooh. No, you could probably type that into YouTube, honestly. You don't like sweet wines, really? That's why I like whites. I have like a girly taste, girly tongue. I really like sour beer. And I really like sweet wine. I don't really drink wine all that much, but that's why I love port. It's just sweet. Oh, it's delicious. And it makes me, yeah, hard ciders are great, but I do like a good beer every once in a while though. I'm not like a heavy drinker, but yeah. Although ricin, Tata, I think we have Tantric. Pinotage? I never even heard of Pinotage. I can't have really if I have something really sweet with alcohol in it, I will be on the ground writhing in pain from my little tummy. San Antonio or South Africa is famous for it? Interesting. I was going to say San Antonio. SA is San Antonio for me. Trunk. Ooh, Antarctica. Wait, how do you spell Antarctica? Is it Antarctica? How do you spell this? Antarctica. Thank you. Not a word in the list. Wait. Doesn't work. Sorry, I'm not even paying attention. Antarctic? Arctic? Antarctic. Already found. Okay. Truncati? From you have to gotta truncate a bunch of stuff. Antarctica. Is that a arnica? What the heck is that? Yeah, Antarctica. Tarn. Alas, what does that mean? What do you mean? How you realize that I'm old? Oh, odd. I thought that said old. I was gonna say, how do you know I'm old? How do you know I'm odd from this? Apparently I can't read either. I might need glasses. Yeah, also very old. I drink port, come on. I'm like an old grandpa, according to Cecilia. I am very odd. Everyone's old to you, Nemo, come on. The poor incomes give you away. Carrot, good. I am a very odd man. That's very true. I ain't got no shame in that. Ooh, cataract. Awesome. I could get real weird on stream sometimes. Like some people do this for like a living, and they just like take on different personalities. Like, have you guys seen a sketch on Twitch. It's like he's like taking over the known world right now. Attractant. Oh my gosh, that was crazy. That wasn't even, that was only 10 points. That should have been like 50 points. Citrin. It's like these people who act completely different on stream. I could do that. I could like adopt a personality. And that stream. And we can get real weird on this. Unitarian. Anybody Unitarian here? Whisper Daddy. I can do, I can, that'd be the first thing I'll get into, Whisper Daddy. Honestly, I really want to do this, but I don't think I legally can. That sounds weird. Irritant. I want to read the whole Harry Potter series with different voices. Like, not, I'm not practicing. I just like have a desire to do that. Like to give it a shot and to get like real weird with it. But I probably legally can't do that. I don't know where to do it. I'm like, maybe I do Twitch. Maybe I do it on Twitch and just delete the stream immediately after. Yeah, like I'll try a British accent. Like, imagine me trying to read the whole thing in a British accent. Did I tell you guys that story once? You know, you guys probably, you might not remember this. So in the old season two with Abby, do you remember when we did the interview with our two friends, Brandon and Christine? I gotta research British accents. I know, that's why I think I could like do it live and just delete them. I would definitely have to delete them after. But Christine, the other person that we did the interview with, which was like wrapping up all of book one, it's still on YouTube somewhere. I think it's still on our channel. But when we were wrapping up all of season one with them, Christine had this moment where her old roommate, when we were all kind of in the same like apartment complex, her old roommate, who was like her best friend at the time, Christine was sick. Or no, her roommate was sick, and Christine came and read the entire like first three chapters of Harry Potter in a British accent for her. She's one of my favorite people. She's so like thoughtful. It was so funny when she told me that. I was really sick, and she was like, yeah, Christine came in my room and just kind of read me the first three chapters of Harry Potter in a full British accent, doing all the different voices. did someone say something wild? Yeah, British accents, sorry. Alas, you're just here for my... my oddity. I respect that. We're almost done. We're getting there. We have like 3-4 chapters left. How many? We have 3 chapters in the prologue. It deleted your last message. What did you say? What was your last message? After the book, we have more seasons. Danny and Jen are going to do a second read, probably. And include some of Jen's family in it, which are hilarious. They're so funny. So there's some plans. Yeah, something crazy provocative. Nemo is getting real provocative with it. I have to say, Becky, answer me this, riddle me this. Do you find that accents existed more? I think Jen is gonna reread the series. Like Jen's timeline has only increased with her love of it. Like Jen had a time where like halfway through she was like really busy at work and she was like, maybe like, oh great, like we have to go to the pod again. It was like dragging and she's like, okay. But now that she's like, we're almost finished and she's going to have just time to be able to like reread the books how she wants to reread the books, I think she's really up for it. And she wants to keep doing stuff on the podcast, which I love. Like she's really into it. I think Danny's kind of talking to her about how like fun this is. And I think she's really enjoying it. Danny is just always going to enjoy it. Kristen is 100% out after we're done with this. She's already tapped out. I know, I have to wait 70 years, really? So when I'm 104, I'll have like my nieces and nephews publish it. Okay, I was gonna say, Becky, do you find that all the accents in Great Britain are kind of not necessarily morphing into one, but like are Great Britain accents getting more distinct with each region, or are they becoming less distinct with each region? Because I will say America, I feel like, is becoming less distinct. I don't know if it's the just general like location of everything, but like I'm from Jersey and everyone knows what a Jersey accent sounds like, and I don't have a Jersey accent. I say certain things weird and like some of it comes out, but compared to other people who live in Jersey in different parts, I think, yeah, Katie, I'm with you. I think everything is being more generalized. Like my sister-in-law is from the South, and every once in a while she'll say something and I'm like, oh, that's a South accent, but that's like very rare. She just sounds like she just talks like me. It's not really necessarily an accent. And I feel like that's kind of across the board. Maybe like 50 years ago, accents were more of like a thing, definite a thing. But I feel like maybe like a younger generation. Yeah, with TV, video, audio, I kind of feel like that's a, it's definitely the truth. I don't know. That's a great question. Nandel, do you find that's true in Swedish too, with Swedish accents? Your Fort Worth, Dallas family, yeah. There, like when I lived there, there was a few people with, you know, the twang, but there weren't that many. It wasn't like a huge contingent of people who had a different twang to it. I've been doing a little research, just random research into the transatlantic accent and like why people spoke in the transatlantic accent. And it's a bizarre phenomenon why people spoke like that. And it was almost such like a broadcast voice. Yeah, I kind of love it too, but I don't understand it. It was like how people just speak differently in when they're like doing different things. Katherine Hepburn, a great example, yeah. There's no generic accent, interesting. They spoke it because it was easier to hear over radio? No way. That's really fascinating. It does kind of make sense. Wait, is this ABBA? What ABBA song is this? All right, let's do the crossword. We get a long one today. Everyone associated with intelligence. I mean, it kind of does sound kind of cool. Money, money, money. Thank you. We're doing this. Man, I am still bummed that Iowa lost. It hits me in waves. Ah, would have been so great if they won. Let's knock it out. Okay. We're doing this. Rear ends. Cabooses? Mensa prereq? No. Lightweight curtain fabric. IQ test? Oh, yeah. That makes sense. Lightweight curtain fabric. Linen. Voile. Viola. I feel like linen's not that lightweight, but maybe. Maybe it is. I don't know. I don't know my fabrics. Folded brunch fare. Folded brunch fare? Is that like an omelet? Omelette, yeah. Omelette is spelled so many weird different ways. Tito, who wrote Oi, como va? I don't know. Song performed 3 times in The Wiz. Puente. Thank you. Give a kick, say. Give a kick, say. What American Airlines means in poker lingo? Fold, because they folded? Did American Airlines fold? They're united now? I don't know. Oh, double aces? Yeah, maybe aces. Yeah, that makes sense. I just thought of that after. Igor. Nice. Chiopino ingredient. What's Chiopino? Crumbly coffee house confection. Ooh, crumbly. That's good alliteration. Crumbly coffee house confection. Scone. Chiopino ingredient. I could say that in really Italian. Okay, let's talk pet peeves real quick. Hold on, real quick. As a side note, does anything irk me more than when someone is talking in a specifically normal accent and all of a sudden they whip out like if someone's like, what was her name? Giada De Laurentiis did this all the time with Italian stuff. And it bothered me so much where she's like on her cooking show. She's like, oh, and then you take the, you know, the pasta and you pour it into the tub and you get spaghetti, and she would say it all sorts of, like, I'm like, dude, just say it like a normal human being. We say spaghetti, don't just like flip-flop accents whenever the heck you want. Or like, what's the like if someone's doing something and they're about to go to like a bakery and they're like, oh, I'm gonna go, you know, get a croissant. I'm like, shut the heck up. Yeah, Giada always annoyed me too. Rachel Ray was always my girl. Rachel Ray was the best. Container for movie popcorn. Ooh, a butt, because we saw what they were handing at Dune, a tub. Blank Nation, annual music festival. Rock Nation? Wes, what's up, bud? Oh, $40 a day was great. That was a great show. That would never last today. $40, it's like $40 an hour now. One place to find a pair of parrots. A pair of parrots. I agree to an extent. So like, yeah, but if I... There's a fine line between things. Like, what was, Inglourious Basterds is a good example of this, where the Brad Pitt's character has that real like Texas Southern accent. And he says everything in the accent that he wants to say it in. You don't go there, but you have to, I can't be like all of a sudden in the middle of it, be like, Chipino ingredient. Like, I gotta, you know, be consistent. Yeah, honestly, that is a great Brad Pitt film. He looks great in that one. Has anybody seen Brad Pitt lately? That dude has gotten some injections or something like that, and he looks very young. Whatever he did worked. Wait. Wait, what do you mean? No, I am saying he's beautiful, right? He looks even better. He, like, all the wrinkles are gone from his face and it looks kind of natural. Croissant? Yeah. I'm going to say, can I please have a croissant, please? I'm not going to say, can I have a croissant, please? You just say it in your normal accent and people got to stop going crazy. What is a backless stool? I don't think they are either. I actually kind of like some wrinkles, but you know, he like looks not fake, which is nice. Kenny Rogers? Does Kenny Rogers look terrible? I haven't seen what Kenny Rogers looks like in a long time. DFW stat? Dallas Fort Worth stat? Ooh, yikes, dude. When the eyes start to go poofy, that's like, yikes. Brad Pitt is a good looking dude. He's had phases too. This is my favorite Brad Pitt face. Actually, I take that back. Inglourious Basterds isn't my favorite Brad Pitt movie. My favorite Brad Pitt movie is Moneyball. Simon Cowell does look a little scary. Jerry Jones looks terrible. Honestly, like I know she's the queen, but Dolly Parton. I'm like, people just need to accept aging, you know? Like, stop getting all that injection stuff, you know? I don't think Dolly Parton pulls off. I mean, she can do whatever she wants, but ETA maybe, yeah. Riddle me this. Riddle me blank. Riddle me Benjamin Button. I really didn't like that one. Riddle me Thelma and Louise. Can someone figure this one out? What is this one? Group with the 2009 hit, I Got a Feeling. Is this like a rebus? Boldness. Yeah, I think there's something up with this puzzle. Apple variety whose name sounds like part of a flower. Yeah, it is them. I think there's a rebus in this though. We haven't figured it out yet. Steph Curry and LeBron James example. Ballers? If it's ballers, I'm going to kind of be mad. In the middle of the puzzle, black boxes shape an S. Wow. If you really squint, you can kind of see it. That's weird. You skip the S's? Ohioans, wow. It's ridiculous. Yes, Captain. Aye, aye. Move quickly through. Move quickly with the word through. Pinnacle. Zenith? I don't think so, because it's a Z. Merida, mister. Layering garment. Number of Gospels in the New Testament. 4. Ann Kuntz. Vest, I like that. Dean Kuntz, yeah. Is Ann Kuntz the writer? Author. Oh, yeah. Is Ann Kuntz a writer, too? I feel like I've heard of Ann Kuntz before. Laird for Merida Master? Also, if you're behind, hit live so I don't get all thrown off. Big Ben? Fitness Enthusiast's Mantra. One more rep. I don't know. Big Dick. Old Italian currency. Is it like the peso? I don't know. Protein, bro. That's not a bad one. The One Who Got Away. First Love. Lire. Yeah. Everyone, who is the one who got away for you in your life? Japanese vegetable. Bok choy. Baby bok. Lira. Thank you. Suffering memory loss. Dementia, suffering memory loss. Amnesia. Nice, yeah. Thanks, Becky. You don't have a one who got away? Nandela's like, I'm the one who got away. Unless it's a horse. That was a great answer. Everyone that got away, you're glad they got away. Wow. You guys really don't have one that got away? Start of some cautionary advice. Precheck org. POTUS's military title. What's mine? Who's mine? I have two. Sometimes my husband wishes he got away. Did him. Toodles, I feel like you're behind. Because I don't know what you're answering for that one. Chief? It's not chief. Unless chief is for a different one. They pick their own title. They pick their own military title. And I don't know what Biden picked. And is typing slow. Wait, signed? Sinned? Commander in chief. Gotcha. Yeah. Wait, commander in sync? Yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, it's a military title. Bird whose first letter is silent. Wren. Nice. Baby bird. Baby girl. Baby. I don't know. Baby Yoda. I kind of like Baby Yoda. Baby girl? Baby doll? Could be a lot of different things. Low-lying wetland. Low-lying wetland. Marsh, yeah, 1 second. I gotta do some real quick, and then we'll be done. Swamp or marsh? Baby wipe. I kind of actually really like baby wipe. I feel like it might be baby wipe. All right, we'll go marsh for this one. I really like June's answer for baby wipe here. I think that's a natural one. Real looker. Ah, man, the one who got away. Ah, hottie, such a hottie. List ending abbreviation. Mean. Rubs the right way. Hey, wow. Excuse me. Unkind, I like that. Why don't you bring them back? Who, the ones who got away? Because they're both married. Erases. Ah, rubs the right way. Close. Unkind. Why did you capitalize the D? Yeah, I'm not a marriage wrecker. Surfboard kayak hybrid. What are those things? Waterboards? What are those things called? Oh, sorry, Nandala. what the heck are these things called? I forgot what they're called. Later, Lost. Thanks for joining. I don't know. Casey of Classic Radio. Oh my gosh. Orlando just got dark. Oh my god. What the heck? No, thank you. Gosh. Take advantage of an opportunity. Wow, that just came out of nowhere. So Cecilia coded. Oh my gosh. Oh, and no, thanks. Yeah, she's just putting words in Cecilia's mouth. She just beat Cecilia to the punch. Where the buck might stop. Alex and Blank jewelry brand. 2022 number one hit for Taylor Swift. Any? Snoopy to Charlie Brown. Pet? Dog? Actress Campbell of the Scream films? I only know Naomi Campbell. Wait, anti-hero? For T Swift? Neve? Neve Campbell? That's a cool name. New York City subway in its. In its. Stops? Oh, MCA, yeah. Makes sense. I don't know, Neve Campbell. I've never seen the Scream things, the Scream movies. I think I've seen her in anything. If she's in a bunch of action stuff, then I really haven't seen her in stuff because I don't really watch a ton of action movies. Skyscraper. I haven't seen any one of these movies so far. Lion King 2, Simba's Pride. She's in a lot of like soft pornos. What the heck? Like Intimate Affairs. I haven't seen any of these. I haven't seen a single one of these movies. I'm not too young. I'm not saying I do. I'm saying some of those movies are soft porn. They look like it. Former African country and its currency. What was Congo for? They changed it back to the DRC. I think it's talking about the Congo. What did they call the Congo? It was the Belgian Republic of Congo, then it was the Congo, and then it was something. I think it was a five-letter word, and then they went back to the Democratic Republic of Congo. This is going to bother me. I know Nemo knows it. Ah, son of a gun. Zaire, yeah. You don't think it's Zaire? Because of the Z? Or just because it's probably not Zaire? That sounds like a country, or that sounds like a currency as well. Yeah. I can't do scary movies. I'm not going to do a scary movie. I've shown you guys the scariest scene that I've ever seen in the movie Signs, and I will never do that. Jewish right for an eight-day-old. Snip, snip. Wow, four-letter words? Isn't this circumcision? Breeze? Is that what circumcision is? Breeze? What is breeze? Isn't it 8 day circumcision? Wow, we're talking about circumcision way too much. Let's see, well, he won't lock a woman in his basement. Too scary. Yeah. I guess it's breezy after. My brother and his friends watched a scary movie. They watched all the Saw movies, which aren't really scary. They're just gory. I've never seen those, but I won't watch them. Breeze. It's not pronounced breeze. Brize. Briss. How do you pronounce it? Or is he just pretending? I'm just pretending that I don't like him. No, Cecilia, that's you. Briss? I forget. Soft briss. What is it though? Is it circumcision? Briss? Oh, interesting. Weather the storm. What is weather the storm? But my brothers were watching it, and the house that I grew up in had a terrifying basement. It was like a pull open basement, and it was pretty scary. And they just went down there and they were like messing around, and I'm never gonna do that because of that reason. So and ho for dough, say. What the heck? Farm? Alright. F-14 fighter jet.
Hello, Wes. What's up, buddy? You enjoy your bone? Hey, you are such a good boy, bud. You really are.
Tomcat? You love to see it.
Wes, you're like just at arm's length. You gotta come here closer so I can pet you. If you want some snuggles and some pets, you gotta come over here.
So I'm not reaching my full arm out. Yeah, I'm not paying attention to the puzzle at all either, which is okay. Just chilling. That's what a chill puzzle is. You love to see it. Fashion designer Pucci. Pucci! Yeah, we're just hanging out. Emilio Pucci. Emilio. Broke a national park rule. Pet the wildlife. I don't know. Emoticon's mouth for short. Apple processing plant.
Aw, Wes. You are such a cutie. You're such a cutie. Yeah, you're a cutie. I'm saying you are a cutie.
Love you, bud. Cidery, nice. Winery, but for cider. Cidery! Church parts vulnerable to lightning. Steeple? Anybody ever see the steeple chase in track is the weirdest event that I've ever seen in my life. Hip spot for a drink. Flask? No food for me, thanks. I've eaten? Because I think this one is... And is there something weird? I've eaten. Is that so? Wait. Something weird is going on. Double E's. I've eaten. Adorbs. So cute. Too cute? Black-eyed pee-pee? No way. For real? Blad? Wait, hold on. Katie, what are you on about right here? Angle measuring instrument. Black eyed. I still can't do that. So this one is double P. How the heck does this make sense? Two E's in this. Going this way? Black eye pee pee. What is this one? Ease on down the road? I get it now. Ease on down the road. Wow. Angle measuring instrument? What are those things called again? Wow, Katie, that was impressive that you figured that out that early. Ransom Eli Blank, pioneering automaker. Aces. Olds? An Oldsmobile? What the hill is a metonym for? Congress? Elizabeth! What's going on? Lizzie, when are we going to record next? No, I just texted you, but I forgot to respond before, but whenever you can, text me and we'll figure it out. I-I-E-I. Huh? Recess retort? AM2. Daytona vehicle. A sign bar? All right. Stock car. Let's go on red. Hold on. No way. I would never leave you on red. Lizzie, okay, I'm not even messing this up. This is, you texted me this. It's in, I have this in unsent, but it's just sitting there in unsent. I am so sorry. Sorry. I feel so terrible now. I just sent it now. At all, yeah. Wow. Lizzie, I'm so sorry. I'm not the one who got away. Calm. Sedate. Computer addresses for short. IPs. Queso. Huh? Cecilia, hold on, time out. The basement is getting more believable because I didn't text someone back. That's where Cecilia's mind goes. I don't text someone back, so I accidentally don't text someone back. And I'm hiding people in my basement. Teacup poodle. Nice. Belgian surrealist painter James. Peach pit. Doctrinal belief. I don't know. You're good, Lizzie. I know you're chill about that. I'm just defending myself in front of these other lunatics. The thing of locking people in my basement. Clam. That seems right. June, I like that. Season. Nice. Are you quitting a movie or something? You guys are just trying to put the blame on me. The Good Blank. Emmy winning series. The Good Wife. Ugh. Bread spread. Mayo. Well. Still awake? Afro Nation. Riddle me. Mayo's good without thinking about mayo. Like if it's on something and I don't know it's on something, I'm like, oh, it's good. And yeah, mayo and bread. Ali. A-L-I, zodiac animal, a ram, like putting a knife in a mayonnaise jar and just taking it out is anti-ASMR. It is the most disgusting sound in the world. It's like cotton mouth. Ugh. Ugh. Joy Bayer. June, and I will never have mayo on a sandwich again now that you said it that way. I know, Toodles, I'm with you. I just keep saying riddle me this for that one. emptier. Bleaker? Butter cutter? Dun, dun, dun. Amazon Prime vehicle. Cat crackers. What are you on about for cat crackers? Where's cat crackers? Nerve. Early name and digital recording. RCVA, right? Unlikely donors to AARP. Ageists? Kinda close. Nearish. I don't know this one actually. Hello, Presh. Hi, come here.
Go get a toy. Go get a toy. Where's your toy? Where's your toy? What you got? What you got?
Apogee? Pinnacle? Ooh, Lizzie. Me too. Pennsylvania City. Senia? Pennsylvania City that's home to Gannon University. Erie? It's always Erie. Amnesic, thank you, yeah. Seneca. Luau finger food. Dog, like a hot dog. Mini wiener hot dog thing. Move quickly through. Rip through. Boy. I'm gonna get taken because the NSA is looking at this chat thinking that I have someone in my basement. So when I go to prison next week and you guys miss the crossword streams because I'm in prison, you'll only have yourself to blame. Get out of here, you little stinker.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Oh, get out of here. Get out of here, you little stinker. Oh. Wes, we'll go on a little walk and like 20 minutes, okay? Like 20 minutes, all right, you little stinker. Maybe you just want to wrestle.
You are so cute. Session, thank you. I don't have a basement, no. I live on the top floor of a two-family, guys, so I don't have a basement. Best animated feature winner of 2021. Encanto! Ah, J-Pulse, bummer. I know. I like Twitch a lot better than YouTube, but it seems like YouTube is bringing in more people, more of the community. Wow, that's really weird. You guys are so dark that you think of this stuff. Senor, for what? Curve line between musical notes? Slur? Really? Hot cocktail. What, so you're gonna lie that I don't have someone on my basement? Hot toddy? It's not wipe, it's Yoda! No way! That's wild, Katie. I did not think it was gonna be Baby Yoda. blank speak. I kind of want to watch The Mandalorian again now. That was a good series. blank speak? Isn't that text speak?
What are you doing? Come here. Go get your toy. Wes, go get it.
Where to see the midnight sun? Arctic Circle. Barbieheimer in the summer meme? I think it's unkind, unfortunately. Aaron Judge. Example in brief. Yankee. And why Yankee? When a football may be snapped on two. Yurt. What are you saying yurt to? Oh. Lizzie, can we have a play date with Wes and... Oh, ouch. You okay, bud? Wes and Moose soon. A word to the wise. Wow. Katie, that's cool. In agreement to Aaron Judge. Gotcha. A word to... Lizzie, do you like baseball? Blank to speak. Walt Whitman, notably. So to speak, yeah, thank you. The only sport you watch? Baseball? No way. Baseball's the most boring sport to watch. Tennis is kind of fun to watch. Women's basketball was so fun to watch this year. Oh, Caitlin Clark, no. Fail miserably. Oh, kids are at grandma's. Love that tank, yeah. Dun, dun. Dun, dun, dun. Lizzie, are you a Yankees fan, though? I feel like you're a Yankees fan. The Mets are historically bad, so I hope you're not a Mets fan. Preamble start. We the people of the Constitution, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice. Promote the society of elfish welfare. I'm just kidding. Nutritional fig. Oof. What's up, Melanie? Are you new here? RDA? Melanie Mediros. I like your last name. Becky, that's the cult of the Estados Unidos. You are so cute. Oh, I love you, Wes. Melanie, welcome to the channel. We do crosswords on this one. We do it on Twitch sometimes, but we're mainly doing it on this one right now on YouTube. And my cute dog, Wes, likes to play tug of war with me while I do crosswords. If you don't like crosswords, that's okay. None of us are really good at them except for like three people. I'm not going to say which three people, but we all know which three people here are good at crosswords. The rest of us are just like hanging out. The preamble to the Constitution. Yeah, it's the preamble to the Constitution. Every second grader memorizes that. Like love on Valentine's Day, it's said. In the air. Yeah, love is in the air. Bad spot to leave food unattended.
You are so cute. I love you. I love you.
Rain in the schnoz. Celia is one of the best. Celia is the drinker of the group. This is like an office thing. So Celia is like the drinker of the group. Nandella is the one that's... Hold on. This is Nandella. I gotta find this meme. No, this doesn't really make sense. I thought it was like watching out of a window. I feel like Nandella's the one that like there's like a window blinds and she's like looking up at the window blinds every once in a while and then she shuts them and then she opens them and shuts them whenever she wants to comment on something.
What are you doing? You were just the cutest.
Hold on, I'm just gonna put this on Wes because Wes is just looking so cute right now. Sorry, they probably gave everyone a headache. He doesn't know what to do. Isn't he so cute? He's like, hey guys, I'm Wes. Welcome to my channel. I really like to, you know, play tug of war and I don't really want to be on this anymore. So I'll see you guys later. Yeah, the preamble is just an introduction to the Constitution. On two. What is bad spot to leave food unattended? Also, we haven't heard Oh, what the heck? Ooh, campsite is great, yeah. John being the boss in this analogy. What is the analogy here? Melanie was out. I don't know if she's still here. She's like, I don't know about these people. Laundry purchase in an orange container. In an orange container. Belgrade resident. Yeah, I'm not the boss. I'm just the scribe. I'm like the secretary for you guys. Tide Pods. Remember the challenge or the trend that everyone is eating Tide Pods for like 2 weeks? Belgrade resident. A Serb. Service center. I've been in your office. That's right. Now you guys, yeah, you guys have been in the headmaster's office. That was actually really funny when I did that. I still have the headmaster's office. I haven't really called anybody else into it, but I still have the headmaster's office. Service center. Tympanostomy performer for short. What the heck? Is it Ent? No way. Yes. Iraqi city on the Tigris. Mains. You betcha. Samara, Antres. Former TLC reality show set in a Florida tattoo parlor. You pronounce Iraqi in a way that gives you the ick. Miami ink? It gives you the ink or gives me the ick? Iraqi? Isn't it? Because it's like, you don't say, it's not Iraq. It's Iraq. Iraq. Right? Iraq? I don't know how to really say it. That's like one of those things. I know. I'm going to keep saying it like that. Keep giving Becky the ick. Standards of behavior. Oh, yeah, yeah, it's true. Becky, that's a great thing. That's like that's what I'm talking about, the fine line between it. I was on a whole thing about it, but that's the fine line. I'm not going to say I'm from Iraq. Iraq. Or Iraq. It's Iraq, right? Or like Iran. Morals, thank you. OTC part. Over the country? I don't know. What is the C? It's okay. No problem. I don't know what the OTC part is. Is it over? I'm guessing it's over. Like some credit cards. No fee. Really though? Is it? Over the counter, thank you. Oh, over the counter, thank you. PC shortcut. Control. A little horse. Bowl a foul, right? Bowl. Foul. Bowl. Emerge with Bell Atlantic to become Verizon. I don't know. Sprint? Foul or birds. Thank you, Bria. I like that Bria didn't talk before, and that's the only thing. Bria just came in. She's like, John, put it on pause. Sight for sore eyes. Foul is a bird. That's a good one. I'm glad that you're here. See, this is crazy. On YouTube, we had like 16, 17 people at that one moment. We never have that on Twitch. So I feel like I'm going to keep doing this on YouTube, and then maybe we'll just do extra ones on Twitch. No, I'm not ignoring you. Wait, CC the moment, John. Oh. This is why I keep, like, this was a Canadian way of something, of saying something. Like, I thought you guys were still talking about the ick. So, I thought you were saying CC the moment. I don't know what the heck it meant, of being like, hey, forward John to the moment when he said that this is what gives him the ick, you know? That's how my mind works. GTE, littered. With it. Yeah, HEP is a version for hip in a weird way. SPF, yeah, yeah. Perrin? Emoticon's mouth for short? Huh? Parentheses. Wow, that's a little bit of a stretch. Wake ski? What is a surfboard kayak hybrid? Wave ski? Service center is a V? Yeah, I never called it Perrin. Yeah. Service center is a V. That's ridiculous. It's always something that's like stupid like that. Escapee. Streak on a cheek. Tear. Oh, like just what I was doing before I started this the crossword, crying that Iowa lost. Well, I wasn't crying that Iowa lost. I was crying that Caitlin Clark played her last game in college athletics. An Otis, gotcha, that makes sense. Utah? The greatest snow on earth, really? It's true. Are you up? You. What is this one? Bleak is wrong too? Where's bleak? Okay. Use it or lose it. Use it or lose it, sister. Aye, sir. Bearer. Wait, Lizzie, what are you saying stop about? TiVo. Come on. Vest. There you go. Riddle me. Are you up? Riddle me re? What the heck is riddle me re? Crying for my girl. I wasn't, yeah, it was a sad moment. I cry because she was crying. That's why I get emotional. Tamaray, okay, we still have something wrong though, which is a real bummer. This is a Sunday. So I cry when reciting their preamble. No, I'm not a real empath. I'm an empath with certain things. With certain little niche things. Stay man for 43. I like it, Justin. Just coming in, fixing the puzzle. There it is. Yes. That was awesome. I love Justin's only answer is just to fix the puzzle. It's called an unhealthy parasocial relationship. Is that the new term for empath is? Ooh, that's rough, Becky. There has to be some kind of like block that you can't do that all the time. You can do that sometimes, but you can't do that all the time. That's tough when you just do that all the time. I know, 98-day streak, guys. Lizzie, you're still young. I don't know why I was never like this, and then all of a sudden I hit like 30 and I got like emotional over like commercials. It's like, I don't know what the heck it is. I'd be crying in my own time, that's kind of true. Yeah, most of the time I feel like I can ignore that, but there's just certain moments that it hits me in. And seeing, this is what I'm talking about, guys. I might tear up watching this again, because they have this on this. I don't know if they're going to have it. Ah, they took it off. Why would they take that off? Come on, show me if they have this video. this. Guys, this might make me a little teary-eyed again. You show me a group of people getting over their differences and banding together and you're broken. Okay, to preface this, guys. Okay, hold on. To preface this, because this is a beautiful moment in sports right here. This girl right here got injured at the beginning of the season. And she was like easily one of their starters. She was an incredible point guard. She was like part of the glue that held the team together. She was fantastic. And a few days ago, she was healing and there was a possibility she might play in this game. And her coach sat her down and said she can't play. And she immediately wept. And I got a little teary-eyed over that too, because that was kind of like a beautiful moment, because her coach is great. Her coach is fantastic. So she comes into the game for Caitlin Clark. And another lead up to this is Caitlin Clark. Dude, Caitlin Clark has been playing basketball her whole life. And everything has been trying to lead up to this moment. She got to the national championship last game and she lost to LSU. She beat LSU this year and she played up against South Carolina, a team that was drastically better than Iowa in every single play. They were incredible. South Carolina is unbelievable. And they're 37-0. They haven't lost a game. And this is the moment that I got real teary at. I was watching the game and I kind of lost it at this right here. You could tell she's about to lose it. I'm about to lose it. Oh my gosh. Look at her. She's starting to get a little weepy. She's trying to put on a nice smile and then she just loses it. Oh my gosh. Like, this is the culmination to her. This is the culmination of everything that she's worked for at this point. She's changed the sport of women's basketball more than any other woman has ever changed it. And she's coming off for her last college game. Oh, she worked so hard. It was so beautiful. I'm so sad. Like, I'm sad for her. Right? That got you? Thank you. It kind of hurts a little bit. It's like, yeah, it kind of gets me. It's a beautiful sports moment. I get like weirdly teary at beautiful sports moments. Like, there's another one that I could find. I think I showed you guys this one before. The first time I watched this, I lost it the first time I watched this, because this fan was so pumped. Hold on. The first time I watched this, just listen to this fan. The passion that this fan has. If any of you don't know this game, this is probably the single greatest soccer game ever played, or the most exciting ending to a single soccer game that's ever been played. It's the most remarkable thing ever. Everyone knows it. Here's Hog. Dini! It's incredible. Go watch it. I don't want to watch the whole first thing before, but so this girl, her team is about, there's a penalty kick. And this team is about to lose because there's a penalty kick in like the 94th minute and it's like game over. He saves a penalty kick. He saves it again, which you can't really see. And she's going crazy. Listen to this fan. Dude, I get so hyped when people get excited for things like this. It's like the dumbest stuff. I remember the first time I saw that, I got so emotional watching that, because it's like a fan just like, this is like, they're not thinking about anything else in the moment. All the cares and worries of the world have gone out of them and they're just enjoying a soccer game and their team won, and I love it for them. It's just a great feeling. It's good. Growing up with sports, it's a good feeling, guys. It's a great feeling. Man. That's all I got. That's my soapbox. Why am I so blurry? That did not get you. That's okay. It doesn't have to get everyone. Most people are going to watch that and be like, oh no, it's okay. I had a hard time. I played D3 soccer. It's not impressive at all. But I had a hard time with my last game. My last game when I came off, it was like, what do I do now? I've been like playing soccer for my whole life and it's just done. It's it. The last game, you're done. That's it. Like you're not playing competitively anymore unless you try to go to the pro level, which, you know, I'm not going to go to the pro level. And so you're just done. And it's a weirdly emotional moment. It's like you've been playing. It's like the end of your childhood. It's like the end of everything that you've been doing since like you've been a child. Like Caitlin Clark, her whole life, she's going to keep playing basketball after that. I'm almost sad for the other teammates too, because like they're just going to have to go on with life being like normal. Yeah, last wrestling match. It's like, yeah, there's like some serious emotional moments with that kind of stuff. In a way that some other things don't have. Like if you're like into music or you're into art, you can still keep doing those things. But like actually with those things, there is like a competitive advantage or like a competitiveness. Like for music, there's like a point where sometimes you're doing music competitively and then it just like ends in your last recital or something like that and it's over. It's like, where do you go from that? It's like actually a profound question. It's, I know this, man, we're getting deep on this stream. Yeah, rugby players are the best. What do they say? What's the phrase that they use in Great Britain? That soccer is a gentleman's sport played by thugs and rugby is a thug sport played by gentlemen. I love that. Rugby players are hardcore. They're great, but they're also like kind and gentle to each other. I love it. It's lovely. It's a lovely sport. I don't know why I'm so blurry. Am I blurry to you guys? Pull the focus. Is it pulling? It's pulling. And we're back, I think, in focus. There we go. Beautiful. Well, I'm not beautiful, but we're in focus, which is beautiful. Yeah, male soccer players are the worst. They're terrible. Honestly, sometimes I really like watching female soccer a lot more because they're actually not necessarily anymore because they're not necessarily tougher. They've like adopted men's soccer. But previously, like Mia Hamm was like, that chick was hardcore. Thank you, Jables. I am beautiful. That's what I say to myself in the mirror every day. I am beautiful. I am smart. I like Harry Potter. But man, today's national women's national final. The tickets were like double what the men's were. And that never ever happens, especially in basketball. I look like Fassbender. Sports players are horrible. Wow. Only insults get noted. Wait, when did you say hottie? Oh, I thought you were talking about male soccer players as hotties. That's literally what I thought you were talking about. It goes over my head. Anyway, guys. I'm jumping off. I'm going to go take Wes into the park for a little bit and just kind of sit in the grass. It's a nice day out, so I'm going to just go chill with him for the rest of the day. Let him go swimming or something like that. It's going to, when is sunset? And then we have an eclipse tomorrow. Wild. It's my birthday tomorrow. We have an eclipse. I also dislike my birthday. So if anybody says happy birthday, I'm going to ban you tomorrow. Deal? Capiche? Okay, good. Ban. I did say tomorrow. Frick. It's supposed to be 66 and partly cloudy. Yeah, it was earlier today. It's literally going to be cloudy during the eclipse from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. It's fully cloudy. That sucks. Why do I dislike my birthday? I don't know it. To be honest, I don't know why. Some people just do. You know that Ron Swanson episode where he hates his birthday? And he tries to do everything he can to get away from his birthday. That's like me. I can't explain it. I don't know why. I just don't like my birthday. I just don't like the attention that I get. I am not really an attention person. So like when I was younger, I hated my birthday because I would come downstairs and all the attention would be on me. And sometimes I remember one year I came downstairs and I saw like a cupcake on my, my parents were great. They gave me a cupcake. For breakfast, and I remember seeing it, and all my brothers and sisters were like, happy birthday, and I remember sitting there, and I cried. I think I was like 6 years old or something like that. It's my birthday in the UK. Thank you, Becky. You hate your birthday, too? And in South Africa. Well, Thanks, guys. But that's it. End in Sweden. That's right. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. It's my birthday there. Anyway, guys, I'm gonna go take a stroll in the park. All right, I won't ban you. Nandela's the only one that doesn't get banned. Da, 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 da. Yes, that is Ron. That is such a Ron Swanson move, though. Jables, have you seen the Parks and Rec episode where he gets his steak and beer dinner, and he just watches like something over the bridge choir or whatever, bridge over the river Kwai, whatever that is. Becky, I don't know why you said 47 seconds. So I'm going to ban you for 47 seconds for that. She just came up with some arbitrary number. You were doing it before Ron Swanson made it cool. I love that. I know Leslie does it for him, which I love because Leslie gets him. But I hate that Leslie tortured him the whole day. Bria, that's a great episode. It's maybe one of my favorite episodes of Parks and Rec because I resonate with it so much. And the one where Ron leaves and he becomes like the park director and he just goes in canoes in the park. I'm like, that's what my life. I want my life to be that. Does Ron not drink beer? Oh, he drinks whiskey or something like that, right? But I love that. That whole episode is so great where Leslie like tortures him the whole entire day. And then all of a sudden she gives him a completely quiet night eating a steak and drinking whiskey, watching a movie that he likes. That's like how I want to spend my birthday. I told Danny this the other day, cause Danny kind of gets that too. Danny was like, I don't want to make a whole big deal out of my birthday. I was like, what I want on my birthday is to be surrounded by some friends that never acknowledge my birthday, but we're just hanging out together as a group. Like Abby, the person who was in season two, she did that for me once, and it was one of my favorite birthdays. They like tried to make it like a little surprise, but we just went to a symphony. And then we went to In-N-Out Burger, and no one said happy birthday to me, and we just kind of hung out as friends, and it was one of the most memorable birthdays that I've ever had. It was just lovely. It was fantastic. I told you 46 seconds and it's enough to rehabilitate, and 48 seconds is just unfair sentencing. I don't understand this, Becky. I still don't understand why 47 seconds. No one is ever around for your birthday? Why? What do you mean? That sinks. The first time readers have been around for almost 2 years, guys. That's crazy. We've been around for a while. We've been around the block. Yeah, true, Becky. That's true. Your calendar reminds you when your birthday is. That's my kind of guy, though, Nemo. Sometimes I forget it's my birthday, too. But my mom always reminds me. But I was born in 1991 in New Jersey. And look at this. My birthday has a record. Let me find this. In 1991, on April 8th, the weather was, I don't know how to read any of these things. It was 91 degrees. I don't know where any of this is. I'm not going to be able to read these graphs and these numbers and charts. But on 1991... wildly, it hit 91 degrees where I lived. And it's like 50 degrees right now. April, it never hits 91 degrees. What is 90 degrees? 91 Fahrenheit to Celsius. It was 32, 33 degrees on my birthday, guys. For you Celsius weirdos. Everyone is on summer vacation here. Bummer. Vivian Westwood. I don't know who that is. She's a store. Wow. I don't know who this is. I still don't know who this is. But she... There you go. April 8th, 1941. Wow. Fashion designer. Cecilia, you're like, what are you, like 89 and you're making fun of 90s birthdays? Please. Your grandma, no way, he's 98. That's incredible. Happy birthday. That's cool. I don't know her. I'm sorry. Vivian Westwood. I don't know who you are. Sorry. Is she still alive? I should have checked her wiki page. Okay, guys, I'm gone because it's almost, it's almost sunset. What time is sunset? That's what I was checking for. Sunset is in 20 minutes, so I'm gone. She died like a year ago. Bummer. Nemo was born in the 2000s, so that's when we're talking. Everyone, what's your birth year? Everyone, real quick before I leave. There's 13 people in here. What was your birth year? Everyone, tell me your birth year. I need 13 answers before I end the stream. I think I've done this like 20 times before. 94. 92. 84. 82. Not 2000. 1998. 91. 99. That's okay, Lizzie. 86. Come on, that's like nothing. 98, 90, 93. Everyone's like, we're like all the same age. Please, come on, stop. We're like the same. Tail end of 99, but still 1999. Nemo, you were born in the 1900s. I'm happy about that. We're all born in the 1900s here. Wow, we're old. We're old, guys. Okay, I'm really going this time. Guys, it was a pleasure, as always. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow, actually, we have a lot going on. Well, not really a lot. We have the crossword, but the green season is coming tomorrow. Mark, Eric, and Liz are coming, and we're going to record in mid-afternoon. Sometime in mid-afternoon. But then we're going to stop to go watch the eclipse. Yeah, Lizzie, you're really an old lady at heart, so. Lizzie, are you watching the eclipse with all your eco buds? Lizzie, you should just come over and hang out while we do the podcast. You're probably working, but if you're not and you're free, just come over and hang out with us as we record and then watch the eclipse with us. I'll text you later. But guys, have a very fun day, night, eclipse day tomorrow. No one is probably going to see it. I think maybe Atlanta. I think you're right over Atlanta, right? Yeah, Jables, you don't get to see it. Who else gets to see it? I don't think anybody else. I don't know where most of you guys are from, really, but I think Atlanta, that's it. Later, guys. Have a great birthday, Whisper Daddy. It's my new name, the Whisper Daddy. All right, guys. I'll see you guys. Yeah, I think you got a little, maybe like a partial. It's going to be cloudy anyway by us, so it doesn't matter. Looking right at. Nice. Love that. Don't be blind because we need you for crosswording. Bye, guys. See ya. Wes is waiting in the corner. He's ready. Bye. See you guys.